I and I want to speak to I and I fellow Afro-American, Rastafari, to the once lost but now found tribe of Judah, of Yehuda, so-called Afro-American Negroes, right? You know, blacks and coloreds, that's the bywords. We know that's the bywords, that's under the curse. But we know that the curse is done away with in our black Lord and Savior, our true black Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach, right? Yeshua HaMashiach, Getachina Med Hanatachin Jesus Christos, right? That curse is done away with. It has been done away with. He's the one that hung on that tree. And yet, many of our people still were in the state of rebellion, that when they said, we have no king but Caesar. You know, we're saying we have no king but Caesar. And we all know about the whole Caesar Borgias, or we should. You know what I'm saying? We should know about the whole Caesar Borgia or Caesar Borgias conspiracy, right? Let me see if I have that again. We may not even have to go there, you understand, right now. You know what I'm saying? We shouldn't really have to go there right now again. Let's just focus on these things right here. So, many of you have heard about Dr. Gladstone Robinson. You understand? You have gotten to know more of him, and we pray that the God of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov, you understand, blessed and rest his soul and the souls of all of I and I ancestors, I and I patriarchs and matriarchs. Many of them who have passed away even recently, you understand, and we've given a word on these and those. Right, and yet in the bigger picture of things too, right? If we look in the bigger picture of things, like from the appointment of Dr. Gladstone Robinson as the Ethiopian World Federation Shashamani Land Grant Administrator in 1967, the fact that he was one of the first Rastafarian, you understand, one of the first of the Rastafari brothers, you understand, as well as an Afro-American. Now, those of us who know the whole link with the Afro-American and the, you know, the Ethiopian link, when we speak about Ethiopians at home and abroad, and we speak about Dr. Malakou Emmanuel Bayan, there goes the link. You know, that's the link where it has been received, to say, like, on the other side. You know, we were speaking about the King of Kings, or of that king, you know, saying that would come forward. You understand that king, and if you look into the Gospel of His Imperial Majesty, another pocket-sized book that we publish, also it goes into some of that information concerning other Afro-American, and I call them Rastafari. We regard in spirit and in truth Dr. Malakou Emmanuel Bayan. You understand? Not just even just as family in the sense of Ethiopian and biblical connection, but real family. You understand? He married an Afro-American woman. You understand? Had youths. You understand? Or had children. You understand? And then he gave his life. You understand? He devoted and livicated his life for this great work. And this is why his testimony, you understand, is so very important to I and I. Now, we might say, well, many of our Jamaican and Benjamite brothers and sisters, you know, they speak a lot about Marcus Garvey. But Marcus Garvey is, you understand, he is like unto John the Baptist. I mean, in more ways than one, you understand. So, and he's an important part of I and I's story. And because we bring the truth forward, some get inordinately, you understand, out of order in the sense of set, you understand, because you know, because they have not been washed from their filthiness. If they really come to the King of Kings in spirit and in truth, they will be able to receive this message in spirit and in truth. And we still hope and pray that they do receive it. But we as Afro-American Rastafari, you know, I and I have to get up and stand up. You know what I'm saying? Not just for I and I own sake, but also for this whole movement's sake. Because we look at this movement, our true Ethiopianist ancestors, you know what I'm saying, going all the way back to the early, even before the turn of the century. There's another book that we have as well Light and Truth. You understand? That was written by a colored man association, or published by them, and black men going through the phases of being Negro and, you know, colored. And but he was now looking and finding Ethiopia. And when you see that particular, you read that particular book, and I would suggest you get a copy of it, Light and Truth, right? Light and Truth. It is such a, and look at the date on it. You know what I mean? When you look at the date on these things, I don't recall the exact date, but if I'm correct, it was like in the 1800s. And then you read through the book and you look at the details and the information, and you say, either this one just was in the treasury, you understand, like some library or some treasury of books, or the Holy Spirit, it's just a combination, just that grace was with them to bring forth, and this, it is all leading to this fulfillment of prophecy. Not just for us as one tribe, or one, you know, North American, African American, or some call us Yankee. You're not just for the Yankee or the Buffalo Soldier. Thank you. You understand? It's more correct if you say the Buffalo Soldier. You understand? The same one that the British said that if they fight, if the blacks fight on their side, they will call them the Ethiopian Regiment. You understand? The same British that still, to a significant level, has many of I and I brothers and sisters in the Caribbean under a colonial, a new age type of colonial, they call it the Commonwealth, you understand? But basically what that means is that your wealth, whatever you possess, they have a first claim or a first dibs on. But that is still also besides the particular point right here. I want to recognize, and I also want to see if I and I brothers or sisters, you know, have the backbone that Jah has given them, you understand, to stand up and recognize that we do have an important role and responsibility, you understand. So the first ones we have to look at is ourselves, is our ancestors, because some of our Jamaican and Rastafari of Jamaican diasporic, you could say, origin, Yovas, who speak certain things about how many of the blacks and the black intellectuals did this and that, and a lot of them did do it. But then we can also say, well, W.B. Du Bois, or Du Bois, you know, whatever, you understand, that was a foreign Gentile name, but still, he, that particular person, he repented, he recanted of many things that he said. Now, of course, there's other rumors people have, like there's rumors against our fathers, there's rumors against I and I, you understand? But always ask for the real, the true value. Give me facts. Give me evidence. There must be some facts or evidence. You can trust that maybe it's true, but verify it for yourself. And this is one of the reasons why we are seeking to publish, and we published this particular book. We said, of all the books out there, there was not a book, and this is just one, this is like book one. You understand, just some of the basic facts, as well as ones about Dr. Gladstone Robinson. So more of us can know the half of the story that hasn't been told. Because if Judah, you know, it says Ethiopia Tikadem, Yehuda Yikadem. Do you know what I'm talking about? Well, we're in the age of judges, you know? Mm-hmm. And we're in a time when there's no king in Israel. There's no king in Israel. And we are also in a time when every man does that which is right in his own sight. And that is a definition of rebellion. That's a definition of lawlessness. That's a definition, biblically speaking, when it says iniquity. You understand? And that's why this testimony of His Imperial Majesty right here, the Ficare Iesus, is so very important. Yovas, and we're working diligently to get the Turgum, or the translation, and a basic level, raw level interpretation of this particular document published by His Imperial Majesty in the 43rd year of his reign. And while I was going through the translation, it was just like Revelation chapter 10 says, you know, because the little book that we received, this is a little book that we received, right, from I and I mother-in-law, Yopa saying she went to Ethiopia and visit, brought back certain books, and she brought this back. And y'all willing, we'll be able to show her what we was able to do with it, Yopa saying, because it's, wow. But it's just like Revelation says, the book is sweet to the mouth. You know, the style of the language, too, is very sweet. You understand? But it says that if one speaks in a language or prays in a language, they're praying to God. And their spirit is, like, built up or is edified. You understand? But the hearer who hears it, who's not able to interpret, you understand, cannot be built up. You understand? So they cannot say amen unless they really overstand. So we're seeking to bring it to that level so that ones and ones can overstand what we have seen while translating and reading this particular book, because it's sweet to the mouth, but then, you know, we had to translate almost like paragraph by paragraph at one point. As we saw it, as we dealt with the older part, like it's a series, it's almost showing us a dispensation from how it would begin, how it would increase, the high points, the real time, the tribulation, and then how the true fullness of the Adis Zemin, when we as the Bani Ha Elohim, the children of God, you understand, when we grow up, you understand? Some say, well, what are we waiting for, Christ to, the Messiah to come again? Nah, that's how you read in your Bible, you understand? That's not according to the true faith. We're not waiting for, we know he's with fire now. We're waiting to grow up in that sonship. You understand, the sons and the daughters, so he can pour out his spirit, as Joel says, his spirit upon I and I. At the same time, he'll be pouring out his wrath upon the children of disobedience. You understand, the children of disobedience and the spiritual wickedness. You understand, the spiritual wickedness, but we have to have that authorization and that exercise of I and I dominion in spirit, in truth, in reality. That's what we have to learn. That's what we have to be discipled. That's what we have to also teach those who are willing to learn. You know what I'm saying? So there's a real mission for I and I as Afro-American Rastafari in particular. Yovas in particular. Another good book for some of the brothers and sisters out there. And it's a, I would say, surprisingly good book, but You know, knowing that Manaman and tribes are people and people, and Judah and Benjamin, or the Afro-American so-called Yankees and the Jamaican Yardies, you know, there's definitely a love there. You understand? And especially in Jah, there's a love of Jah. But we've gone through our ups and downs, and still we have our challenging times. But the more we are truthful and honest, you understand, with our strong points, the strong points of our ancestors, as well as the weak points of our ancestors, then get out of this just rumors. You understand? These rumors. Because a lot of these rumors, some of us are the type of Rasses that we're going to go search it out. You know, we're going to get to the so-called bottom of it. You know, find out the worth of it. And it's so, potentially discouraging, though Christ is the one who says the joy of the Lord is I and I strength. But sometimes it can be so saddening on a certain level when you find out that some of the things that you heard were just completely rumors and vicious rumors. It's almost like, that this virus, we're still under the curse, in other words, and we're not in the new birth, in the new man. You were saying as Rastafari. So Malako Bayan was a Rastafari, if you understand. A lot of folks will look at Malako, right? They'll look at Malako and they'll say, well, nah, he wasn't a Rastafari because he didn't have dreadlocks. Or they'll say he wasn't a Rastafari because he did not smoke marijuana. You understand? Now, who knows if he did or not, really? You know, you really don't know. You know, you can't prove it. I can say, yes, he did. You can't say, no, he didn't. He didn't make that the main message. You understand? Because the message was the King of Kings, was the kingdom. You understand? The kingdom that was under threat because the fascist, the satanic invasion, you understand, of Ethiopia. And there was a bigger supernatural or in the spirit world. Something was going on. And a lot of folks don't really over that. But Fikari Yesus helps to explicate it and make it clear. You understand? Very, very clear to I and I. So We as African American Rastafari, we have a responsibility, and those brothers and sisters who want to co-partner with I and I and the LOJ Society, so we can learn the half of the story. First of all, we need to be informed, you know? We can't just go out there, you know, on misinformation, disinformation. We need to know the truth and be like the Bereans in the Bible. The Bereans, they heard the apostle preach to them, you know, from Sabbath to Sabbath. Mm-hmm. But then they also went to the scriptures and they searched these things out, and they were called noble. It said that they were more noble than those in Thessalonica. I think, yeah, these were more noble than those of another church. You understand? Of another. It's almost like we have Rastafari brothers in Atlanta, you understand, who are fellowshipping with I&I. One's in Canada, you understand? One's in Chicago, you understand? In California and Texas. And, you know, there's what, 52 states, and there's how many countries, nations, you understand? Not in every nation right now that we know of, that we are actively fellowshipping with. But this is the work of Jah. It just says, thou must go. What does it say right here? It says, thou must prophesy. Prophesy again before many peoples. Many peoples. So although we have a role, a responsibility, because Judah is Jah. What is Judah to Jah in prophecy? Judah is Jah's battle axe. You understand? Judah is Jah's battle axe in this. You understand? But the battle axe, in a sense, has become like the battle axe, you know, battle axe, right? But it's the battle axe, you understand? But the thing that the enemy has done is like Bob Marley, Burhana Selassie said it. Then we saw an interview, actually, with a brief portion. We're going to try to check it out on the web. It's on Nightline, and we mentioned this in the other vid, but we'll mention it again right here on Nightline with Ziggy Marley, and they have a new Bob Marley movie. We heard a couple of reviews and reports on it so far. We haven't seen it fly in itself, and we heard that was very, very interesting. Even in the interview, we see where Ziggy and where others, you know, increasingly have either learned this or are recognizing, you know, the role that Afro-Americans also play in this. Many Ethiopians also have recognized this as well, and we see some of the vids, Ethiopic Ada, you understand, and others who have produced certain videos showing that relationship. You understand? This does not dismiss a relationship of Ethiopia or His Majesty with any of the tribes. Because if we look at it, His Majesty, you know, visited all nations. You understand? Just about all nations that are nations He visited, especially the diaspora, where the diaspora is. And we find that in this very town we have Rastafari coming from all these areas of the diaspora. You understand? This is what we have to get over, the whole racial or the hate that hate produced. Yes, Yeshua HaMoshiach, yes, He is black or Ethiopian, if you please. You understand? Yes, He is Ethiopian. That's just a basic fact. That's a natural fact. You understand? Now, it says if we're not able to understand when He gives us the natural things or the earthly things we don't understand, then how can we understand the spiritual or the true supernatural things? Those who say that Haile Selassie says the supernatural is a false concept, they have failed to prove their point. They have only proven that they have added to God's words. You understand? And they must be shown a liar or repent, but still a lie that they lied. They need to repent of that. You understand? They need to say that, well, that's what they read into it, but that's clearly not what He is saying. You understand? And we've touched on that particular spiritual warfare and spiritual wickedness in high places. It's not high and low places. That's something that some Rastafari or some Rastas have said, and it seems to make sense from a natural mind. You understand? But it makes the word of Jah a liar when you, you know, when you recognize the truth and you receive the truth. So on that particular note right there, Burhana Selassie's children, the new movie that's coming out, we want to mention this, Kibbutz Neged. Some of you saw this. Some of you probably already have this right here. This is like the Bob Marley family or Ziggy Marley right here. And it's called the Lost Bible of Rastafarian Wisdom and Faith from Ethiopia and Jamaica, by Gerald Hausman, introduction by Ziggy Marley. It's a very well-produced book right here, and it's a testimony. I recall reading this before, and we was looking for the cover of the guest, right? And we found this, and we read through it, and it talks about this and that, and it has many, many portions of it. I don't know if it's the entire thing right here. It doesn't seem so. You've seen as the entire 114 or so, or 17, 18 chapters. Depends on what manuscript they are using. You've seen this, you've got the Naya Bingi, and then it speaks about, you know, various other particular matters in it. But, you know, this is where the new birth and receiving the true teaching of His Majesty is so important, because the more we receive and we're obedient to that, the more the unity, you understand, is there for I and I. You know, and we as Afro-American Rastafari, we have a, you know, we have a role, I would say even a responsibility. Yovas, and we may see different tribes without Jamaican brothers, Rastafari, who have made certain moves in Ethiopia, Yovas, and some can say they may have outmaneuvered, and we have to give them that, Yovas, and because many of our ancestors, see, Gladstone Robinson gets a lot of hit, or has gotten a lot of hit too, because they say, well, with that authority, more could have been done. I mean, there's a whole political dynamic to when the Dura came in, and also there's a political dynamic to the reasons why one that Solomon Wolf was made that representative for his people, because of Jamaica being under the British and not having an embassy even to this day there. You have to understand, you know, the bigger picture to really understand what's going on there. But this book right here, the final book, we just want to show you. We don't publish this, but this is one we recommend. Some of y'all have it. Check it out again. From Babylon to Rastafari. You'll send From Babylon to Rastafari right here. And this is by Douglas Mack, or Douglas Mack right here, this particular brother. And he has some of the early pictures of him, the other brothers, you'll send, as well as Dr. Gladstone Robinson, or his, by his baptismal name, Fikre Selassie, right? Fikre Selassie, and may the God of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov have mercy on his soul, you understand, and admit him into the heavenly kingdom, you know? But even the whole mission to Africa, you know, was, there's a whole connection, but each of us, we say all hands on deck. You know what I'm saying? We as Afro-American Rastafari, who are also fellowshipping amongst predominantly Afro-American Rastafari, we have to recognize our role and responsibility. A lot of our ancestors, you know, our parents even, they were MIA. You understand? They were missing in action. They started to see what was going on in the West. You know what I'm saying? You have to remember that the Afro-American, we really are the point. To a large, significant extent, we are that point of Jah's spear. You know what I'm saying? We're the point. So when they can dull us down by a lot of this confusion and diversion, you know what I'm saying? They are also able to dull down the whole and the entire movement. But it's a very interesting testimony that is given right here. I want to show you one of the pictures right here. This is the second mission, right? The members in 1963 with Dr. Gladstone Robinson. International, at this time in 63, he was international president of the Ethiopian World Federation. And he's with Otto Ayala Work Abebe, right? Abebe, Ethiopian consul, right? At the Ethiopian consulate in New York, right, in 1964. And there was an African repatriation committee that we're seeking to revitalize, you understand, within the Society of His Imperial Majesty. And well, check this out as well. I think every tribe need to have their African repatriation committee, you understand, because We have to get together on that local level. You know what I'm saying? Among I and I brethren. You know what I'm saying? Among I and I sisterin. You know what I'm saying? And some of us may find ourselves among so-called other tribes. But if there's the love of Jah, you know what I'm saying, in Joshua, then it's all good. You know what I'm saying? In Yahud, in Yehuda. All right? So here's a picture right here. And this is Dr. Gladstone Robinson right there. Right? You know, a lot of times people look at locks, but we know that these brothers over here, they were Rastafari as well, who went on a mission. You know what I'm saying? They were not locksmen, as we would call it today, but they were Rastafari. So how can one say that Dr. Malaku Emmanuel Bayan was not Rastafari in that sense? In fact, he was original Rastafari. So, yeah, brother Gladstone Robinson, a member of the Ethiopian World Federation, he volunteered to accommodate us during our stay in the USA. After the meeting, Brother Robinson drove us to his home in Brooklyn, where he provided us with an apartment, you know, to the mission, that well-known mission, Africa mission, all right? This was our first Christmas away from home. For the first time, we experienced a snowstorm. So this, I don't know if this was 61, you understand, if it was 61 right here. They speak about Brother Robinson drove us from New York to Washington, D.C., so that we could meet with these Africans, to meet with the African ambassador. In fact, Dr. Robinson, we have him on film where he spoke about when Burhana Selassie, or Bob Marley, when he came to perform. And even we have certain pictures of that. You know, we're saying that we would like to bring that forward because it's a part of our story. You know, we're saying all of us, all 12, you know, we're saying as one. You know, we're saying both houses at home and abroad being brought together, that staff, as the prophetic word says, being made one. You know, I'm saying, you know the prophecy about the staff being made, that rod, right, being made one right there. So they go on to say that, with Brother Robinson's sterling assistance. You know, sterling is the silver, the shekel, you understand? And I think silver is redemption. Silver is the metal of is that redemption right there, the redemption money right there. It says, we gathered for weekly meetings at his home in Brooklyn. These meetings were well attended, as were the meetings when he came in 2003. You understand, to see what, you know, what's going on, what was going on over here, and also to, you know, appoint others to carry on, you understand, with this particular mission, with this exodus out of the North Country, which is also found in the prophets, Jeremiah. And out of this came the formation of an organization. Now, Robinson clarifies this, and it should be very well understood that the committee was not a, well, it is an organization, but not in the sense of organization as many think of organization. You understand when you think about being an organ, like we have organs in our body, but they're all part of one organization, our body. All right? Then it says, what was interesting down here, the next part we highlighted, that the ARC, this is on page 122 for those who have a copy or want to check this out for themselves, the ARC members became closely associated with another group of Afro-Americans known as the House of Judah. Now, when we came together as a fraternity, the first Ethiopic frat that we know of in the United States of America and sorority, you understand, the line of Judah, speaking of the line of Judah, before we went to the society or Machiber level, we didn't know anything about the House of Judah in this particular sense. You see, the House of Judah also nominated us as their ambassadors. During our meetings, we asked for special donations towards sponsoring our passage, right? Sponsoring our passage to Africa. So it's a very interesting, testimony. You know, it's like they say, like secondhand or thirdhand or others testifying to this very same truth, so that we can put together, you understand, the half of the story, you understand, that hasn't been told, and really know, you know, the way to move forward and to fulfill that particular word. So let's just conclude this right here. this message to the Afro-American Rastafari from the scriptures. You're right, from the scriptures. Now, you already know the connection. Some of the Israelites, some of our Israelitish brothers, you know, like it says that they are our enemies, right? They are our enemies for the gospel's sake. Let's try to show exactly what we mean. They're our enemies because of Negusa Neges, Kedamawi, Haila, Shilase. Many don't accept his majesty. They call him a false god. They call him an idol. You understand? And this is why the divine word says this about them. And we have to understand the Lord might make us upset. It might make us angry. You know, want to do this. And we have to recognize what the divine word says in this sort of a situation. This is concerning our Hebrew Israelite, you know, our Hebrew Israelite brothers, and, you know, in that sense, where it says it's in chapter 11, right? In chapter 11, it says that as chapter 11, verse 28, as concerning the gospel, let's put that up for there, right there, as concerning the good news, right, of Kedamawi, Haile Selassie, as concerning the gospel, they are enemies for your sake. They are not enemies, you know, for their lies and dissembling. And just the ignorance. It's a deep ignorance. But, this, you know, this too was warned to us. But as touching the election, they are beloved for the Father's sake. As touching the election, right, our Hebrew Israelite brothers, you understand, our lost sheep were there. Remember, it says, any blasphemy to the Father, Abba, can be forgiven, right? Doesn't say that? Any blasphemy to the Son, right, can be forgiven, right? But any blasphemy to the Holy Spirit, that can't be forgiven. So you have to understand what's the difference about it. They are in some of the spiritual biblical prophecy concerning our root. They present this and say, well, this is Christ right here. Isn't this not the work of one's hand? Isn't this not the work of one's hand? It evidently is. You understand? So let's just compare this, right? Let's compare this if we will, right? We have this right here, right? Which one is real? Which one is real Israel? You understand? Which one is real? You understand? And which one is the work of a hand? You understand? That's a picture. This is a real picture. You understand that because of, you know, computer techniques, resolution, you understand, you can bring out more colors. But this is the real living man. This is the King of Israel. And it's our fathers, right? It's our fathers who have said so. Our Beta Israel, Afro-American forefathers, and we presented this before in this particular book right here, right? The Black Jews of Harlem. You understand how Rabbi Wentworth Arthur Matthews, and this is speaking to the so-called Black Jews, Afro-American Hebrews, or Israelites. It says, it is from Addis Ababa that I derive my authority as head of the Black Jews in the United States. These are the fathers that the word says, it says right here. But as touching the election, they are beloved for the Father's sake. For the Father's sake, because of the ancestors, the patriarchs, you understand, like Rabbi Wentworth Arthur Matthews and like Reverend James Morris Webb or Rabbi Arnold Josiah Ford, you understand, all of those who recognize the Ethiopia and Kedamawi Haile Selassie, and also Rabbi Paris as well too. You understand? This is all coming out of our Afro-American Rastafari roots, so we have to recognize how all this comes together. So he says that we are Africans, right, or Ethiopian Hebrews. So when we say Ethiopian Hebrews, this is the context that we're speaking in, all right? And this particular book was published. Let's just give you this if you haven't gotten it already. First printed in 1964. So the very same period of time that we're talking about with from Babylon to Rastafari and Dr. Gladstone Robinson as international president of the Ethiopian World Federation, later appointed as Shashamani Land Grant Administrator and the sole attorney for the organization. Some folks latter Johnny Come Latelys try to. How can you can't dismiss? We can't dismiss the forefathers. We can't dismiss them. You're saying if you're gonna bring a charge or allegation, make sure you have facts, evidence, and it's not the devil bringing you into a condemnation as a liar. You know what I'm saying? And this is why we always check out the evidence and seek to get the evidence up. We hear a lot of stuff and we try to even, you know, give our soul to Christ so we're not all up in feelings, moods, and attitudes and say, all right, that sounds wild, but let me check it out before we, you know, go off and instead of getting into a big fuss and bust. So for the black Hebrew Israelites concerning how this arises, you check out Romans chapter 11. 28, and also the black Jews of Harlem. Of course, some of them might dismiss it, you understand, but that shows what kind of disobedient children, you understand, that we still have amongst us, you understand? Remember, there was Barabbas, there was the two thieves, and there was Yeshua, you understand? So you could get with this, or you can get with that, all right? I, we are with the King of Kings, because it's with the King of Kings is where it is. So let's just go through a portion of this right here, the future restoration, right? The future restoration. Turn your Bibles to Jeremiah chapter 23, just to sum this up for the Afro-American Rastafari, to show that Jah even points out this North Country. Mm-hmm. You have many preachers and pastors who will say to you, well, America's not in the Bible, you know? You mean Amorica? Amorica? Amorica is not in the Bible. And Amor, that was the old name of America even before America was. It doesn't come from Amerigo Vespucci or whatever, the cartographer, the map maker. You understand? It actually goes back to the ancient name that this was known, Amorica. Now, if we look at that name, Amor, not Amar, Amhara, no, Amor. We look at Amor, and that's a vulture, a scavenger. So that kind of tells you a whole lot right there. So it's recognizing how an Ethiopian who does not have that veil on their eyes is able to see this. You understand how His Majesty Himself has seen this is very interesting. So the restoration and the conversion of Israel, so there's many lost sheep. They need to be converted or need to go through the conversion. Not like you hear in these religions and stuff like that. You know, so they need to go from the anti-version to the true version. How about that? It's a message against the faithless shepherds. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, why all this talk about Amen and Hymenot and faith and trust? And because, I mean, don't you get it? Even the Babylonians said after 9/11, we need to restore trust in our system. You know what I'm saying? That's what we need to do as Afro-Americans. We need to restore trust in our system. You know what I'm saying? We really need to do this. So it says right here, there's a message against the faithless shepherds. And what's so very interesting about this particular message is that it goes into the I have a dream. I have a dream is in this chapter too. You know what I'm saying? In this chapter as well, chapter 23 of Jeremiah. So study it, my brothers and sisters, right? A portion of this, just to wrap this right here up, it says, woe to the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord, saith Yahweh, Baruch Hu, blessed be He, saith the Hashem. And the Hashem, Kedamawi, Chayla, Shelah, say the first power of the Trinity, says the Father, right? Therefore, thus saith Yahweh, right? The Elohe Israel, the God of Israel, the Elohe, the Haile of Israel, the power of Israel, against the pastors, it's for the pastors and the preachers, that feed my people. These are the ones, we even saw a pastor out there who was trying to talk about Haile Selassie this and that, and he was getting all mixed up in what Zion is. He couldn't even explain Zion. I know that when most people try to explain Zion, they get confused. Like, they say, well, Zion is like, and you know, is it a mountain? Is it a castle? You understand? What does it really, is it the Ark of the Covenant? You understand? What is Zion? You understand? What is Zion? You understand? Remember, there is Zion and there's Sion. And it's a book by Edward Ohlendorf that is called, I think, The Two is it the Two Zions? I think it's called the Two Zions, which is interesting as well. So anyway, there are pastors, religious folks, right? The ones that put the Caesar Borgias all over the people's frontal lobe. They rub it into the people's frontal lobe, the Caesar Borgias. That's why we like to remind, this is like when the brazen serpent was lifted up in that sense, right, in the wilderness. And Christ said he is likened to that brazen serpent. You understand? Because the people, they had murmured against God, and they was bit by the fiery serpents, right? By the fire, or the seraphim, right? And many of them died, and many of them were sick. That's where black folks are today. Many of our people have died, and many of our people are sick. You understand? But it's a spiritual sickness. It's a spiritual malady or dis-ease. You understand? Dis-ease is the lack of shalom. You understand? They run around talking about no justice, no peace. And they don't recognize that words are cursing them. You're going and chanting that with all of your soul, no justice, no peace. And you wonder why you don't get no justice. Because you don't recognize that this world, this system, the creation is word activated. You understand? And it's not really the people's fault. You understand? On a certain level. Right? And this Yahweh is his word that shows us it's not really the people's fault. You understand? Initially. You understand? Initially. You understand? It's not their fault. Right? Because it's the woe is to the pastors, the preachers. You know, Pastor Bacon and Reverend Porkchops. You understand? It's their fault. Right? Because what they do is destroy. Right? When my people are destroyed or perish because of a lack of knowledge. So, because they don't give them the true knowledge of Yeshua HaMoshiach. You understand? They don't give them the true knowledge of the King of Kings. The black people perish, and they say, it don't matter what color he is. So why you keep pushing on us a white boy from the 15th century named Caesar Borgias, and then his sister, and then the bastard child that appears to be the brother and sister who had sex and had the child, which is called Rodrigo, you understand? And then they put it up. So that's the white Mary or Virgo Mary that we talked about previously. So because they don't give the people the truth, that's why the people are destroyed, the lost sheep. And they are scattered here and there. But they are the sheep of Yahweh's pasture, right? And it says, therefore, thus, like this saith Yahweh, El Elohe Israel, against the pastors, right, that feed my people, that are the stewards for my people, right, that feed them. Ye have scattered, y'all have scattered my flock and driven them away from what? Right, we're showing you right here, even in this book and the other books, the whole connection with Ethiopia, the whole connection with our land, the whole connection with the Exodus, the whole connection with who we be. And these are all things that you can call things that should be preached. You understand? Things that should be proclaimed in the churches. Why don't they proclaim? It's not talking about doing nothing to the white man or whatnot. Like, it's talking about who we be in Jah. Why do they prevent that? Why do they suppress that? You understand? So it goes on to say, ye have scattered my flock and driven them. You see, they're not led. They're not guided. They are driven. And you know, the one who drives on the spiritual level, you understand, are the demons, are the evil spirits and the hosts. And the principalities and the powers, all the ones who are spoken about in the Metzhaf Henoch or the Ethiopic Book of Enoch, and have not visited them. It's amazing you hear pastors talk about they've been around the world in every country. Mm-hmm. And we're talking about Afro-American pastors, right? Like Ziggy Marley said, when I bun herb, I want to read my Bible. I want to listen to maybe music or chant psalms or praise. Or probably do something else, but that's a mystery right there, all right? You know, that's between, you know, the husband and the wife, in other words, if you overlook what Ziggy Marley said. But from the heights, you understand, from the height of it, some folks are immature, so they don't overstand. And that's why you're getting anti-man behavior, you know, just all over the place, buggery. People are bugging out with their buggery, but have driven them away and have not visited them, right? Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith Yahweh. And we're seeing, unfortunately, we're seeing that happen in the black community. So people are like, why is this happening? Why is the black on black crime? Why is all that materialism? Why people don't care about the civil rights movement and affirmative action? And what about, you know, the guy that you elected and stuff, right? And verse 3, it says, and I will gather the remnant of my flock, the remnant, the remainder, the kareta. See, we are of the Afro-American Rastafari. We are that remnant. You understand? We are that remnant of black Israel in the diaspora, right? And he says, he will gather the remnant of my flock out of all, what? Out of all countries. Now, we're going to point to the North country, but here it's saying the all countries, whither I have driven them. Now, you say, wait, it doesn't say right there he has driven them? If that's a correct translation right there, well, you have to recognize even what Psalm, I think, 125 says. You understand? If you want to go there, you can go to Psalm, I think it's Psalm 125, because Psalm 125, which is one of the fire key, I think one of the Psalms I recall we chanted this often in the Naya Bingi, whether it's the fire key Psalms, and we want to do the fire key by Marinya, you understand? They start to put it into the language, and ones can, yeah, right here. It says, they that trust in Yahweh shall be as Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abideth forever, forever. As the mountains are round about Jerusalem or Hierushalem, Hierushalim, so Yahweh, so the King of Kings is round about his people from henceforth, even forever. For the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous. That's our inheritance, brothers and sisters, our true inheritance in the King of Kings and his Christ. It's our divine heritage, Ethiopia. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole connection of who we be in Exodus. Forward ever, the forward to Africa. No more back to Africa, but now it is forward to Africa. Amen and amen. But it says here that for the rod of the wicked, I mean the rulership of the wicked, where the wicked are running everything, the Gentile world dominions are ruling everything, shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous, And the righteous mean those of us who are in Christ, those of us who are born again. You understand? Those of us who are in Christ. If you understand that the righteousness is not ours, what we do, you understand? But it's based on our faith, our immanence in the one who has been sent, Yeshua HaMashiach. You understand? We have righteousness before Abba, Father. You understand? So it says right here that the rod, the rulership, the better of the wicked should not rest upon the law of the righteous, lest the righteous put forth their hands to iniquity. Mm-hmm. You don't recognize when that was done? The March on Washington and everything that came out from it. See, people who say that was it, they don't see the bigger picture. You see, they've been caught up by the tabloid. They've been kind of mind controlled by the media. You know, as soon as they come out of that and they can and receive, if they have a love of the truth, they will receive the truth, and then they'll be able to say, "Oh, our over's now." How that? Could you see the bigger picture? You understand that part? The part of the King of Kings, the role of His Majesty has been suppressed. You understand, has been suppressed and repressed and lied against. So if the righteous put forth their hands to iniquity, what's iniquity? Iniquity is doing what is right in your own eyesight. That is lawlessness. That is rebellion. That is iniquity. So what is evil? Evil is what Jah say is evil. Yeah, and it's simple enough, right? Evil is what Jah say is evil. And he gives us that when we are on his... See, remember, the Torah, or re-Torah, is law, right? But we don't just read the law with the veil over our eyes, but we read it in Yeshua HaMashiach, our black Lord and Savior, so that veil is taken off. So we can really see the shadow, right? It's the Old Testament, but we can see the substance that is casting that shadow with the light, the illumination, you know what I'm saying, of the King of Kings and His Christ. So if the righteous, all those Bible-believing, Jesus-believing black Christians, if they put forth their hands to what? To lawlessness, right? Then the rod, right, when King said that they've given us a check, right? We came here to cash a check. Mm-hmm. He said, we came here to cash a check. You can listen to the speech. We came and we did a kind of a long kind of a expose on portion of that. You can get the vid. It's on our Doc Vids page. You know, we're saying on the dream, you know, the dream lie and everything. But he said we came here to cash a check. You understand? And the check is, and when we went to cash a check, it's marked insufficient funds. And then they can't understand why after that, all the black people were seeking to do was make money in the worldly sense, with no idea of the Al-Qidan, with no idea of the covenant. You know what I'm saying? Look, many have made money. You understand? But you see how they've kind of lost their soul because they didn't do it in remembering the King of Kings and His Christ, or remembering God in for Yeshua's sake. You know what I'm saying? And what that's really about. But it says to do good out there to those that be good, and to them that are upright in their hearts, verse 5. As for such as turn aside, you understand, that was go backwards. You understand, that turn aside, go off of the straight path, and they turn aside to their own crook-hearted ways, right? What it says, Yahweh, Ekaziyah, Erlotu Sabhat, to him be the praise, the sustainer, shall lead them forth. So he who is, the King of Kings, shall lead them forth with the workers of iniquity, with the workers of lawlessness. You understand? You want to be down with that? You understand? That's why what happened in Ethiopia happened that way. They didn't want to accept Christ and his kingly character, but instead they wanted Barabbas. And then they wonder why they get the red terror. You understand? Well, Josh says in Revelation, cast in the sickle. Cast in thy sickle. You understand? The harvest is ready, right? And it says, but the final portion of the verse, but shalom, but salam, but peace, right, be upon Israel. And to clarify that, peace be upon black Israel, I and I, Ethiopian Hebrews, once lost but now found. So that's what it means when it says, whither I have driven them, you understand, under the curse, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15 to verse 68, will bring them again to their fold. Their folds, like their sheep folds. So when we say Afro-American Rastafari, those Rastafari in different regions need to gather their people. You understand? Now is the in-gathering. Need to get ready for the Feast of Tabernacles, the Sukkot. You understand? Of Sukkot. All right? It says, we'll gather them again to their folds, and they shall be fruitful and increase. Right? The prophecies concerning Israel and Ephraim are very, very important to check out as well. And it says, and I will set up shepherds over them which shall feed them. You understand? So there'll be shepherds over each one of these flocks. You understand? Which shall feed them with the teaching of His Majesty and His Christ. Which shall feed them. And to not feed them lies or feed them, you understand, what Margaret Sanger's and those other races, you understand, want people to be fed with. You understand? They say we want to get the Negro preacher is the one to keep the niggas in line in case they suspect anything. And they shall fear no more. We have to do a whole sermon on fear, because fear is faith inverted, perverted. You understand? It's twisted inside out. You understand? You know, if you really have to understand that right there. They shall fear no more, neither be dismayed. Oh, why that happened? Why that's always happening? You know, why does that happen? Why black people always, woe to them, right? But they will not in this time, neither shall they be lacking. You understand? Neither shall they be lacking, saith Yahweh. It says, behold, the days come, saith Yahweh, that I will raise to David a righteous branch and a king. Notice what it's saying. And a what? And a king, right, shall reign over them. And a king, even the King of Kings. This is why in the testimony by Wentworth Arthur Matthews in this particular book right here, he says that Haile Selassie, Ketamawi, Haile Selassie is the King of Israel. He is. He is the King of Israel. I mean, the true, not the state of Israel. That's a state. We're talking about kingdom now. We're not speaking about states. You understand? We're not speaking about states. Like, we could have a village that's called Israel. You understand? And we're not speaking about that. We're speaking about the, you know, the king, you know, and the gospel of the kingdom. You understand? Or the king's dominion, right? So a righteous branch and a king shall reign and prosper and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. Now tell I and I in spirit and truth.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you recognize his majesty? Don't you recognize the work?
Mm-hmm.
Even if you say you don't like him for whatever, judging by appearances or whatever's wrong with you, you're always saying, can't you judge? You understand? Can't you see by the work? Can't you receive the work of him? Do you know the work of him? Now, if you don't, you know, you need to learn. And as you learn, hopefully you will not burn, right? Verse 6 says, in his days, Judah, Yehuda, and we're now speaking prophetically of the Afro-American Negroes, so-called Afro-American Negroes, right? In the Americas, right? The Afro-Americans, they shall be saved. Now, if you notice what was going on in those days and times, you understand, you really have to, even the whole thing with the Brown versus Board of Education, you understand, and the heavy, heavy judgment and words that His Imperial Majesty spoke and warned these people, warned Kennedy, you understand, even warned that Pope before they put in the, I think they put in the imposter Pope and everything afterwards, some switcheroo they did right there, you got to check that out, you overs. But it says right here, Israel shall dwell safely, and this is his name whereby he shall be called, Yahweh Tzidkenu, Yahweh Tzidkenu, or Exiavihir Tzadikachin. You understand? It was our righteousness, or Tzidkachin, Tzidkachin, like Tzidkenu in the Hebrew. So Tzidkenu, Tzidkachin. You can see how, you know, that goes right there together. Tzedekah. He is our righteousness. Now, righteousness also has to do with law. You understand? We have to recognize that law also has to do with even constitution. Also, the basic constitution, the Metav Kedus, but also Ethiopian World Federation. You have to look at that connection there as well. You understand? Therefore, behold, look and see. The days come, saith Yahweh, that they shall no more say. What shall we no more say? It said, the Lord liveth. Or Yahai, Yahai in Hebrew, Yahai, Hiyao Egziyavihirin. You understand? That the living sustainer. We shall no more longer say Jaliv, which brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. So in our Fasika or Pesach, right, we are not to say anymore, because we're in that prophetic dispensation, that Jaliv, which brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But verse 8, Yahai, Yahai, that Jaliv, Jaliv, children, Yea, Yahai, right, which brought up and which led the seed, led the race, right, of the house of Israel out of the what? The north country. Now, what north country do you think we're talking about? We're talking about North America. You understand? We're talking about the so-called Afro-Americans and the blacks and the coloreds and the so-called Negroes. You understand? We already made that connection from the 60s and even before, the black Jews of Harlem. You see that connection. So when we say we're black Jews or Judahites or Ethiopian Hebrews, may it be understood what it is that we are referring to from the facts, from the evidence. And not just from the North Country or out of the North Country, and from all countries. Wow. So we look at that chart of the Beta Israel, of the Hebrew Israelites, and we see all the different countries there. Out of what? Out of what? It says, out of all countries. Can you say all countries? So we have brethren and sisterin and what? All countries, right? Of the sea, right? Whither I had driven them, and they shall dwell in their own land, right? In their own land. So this is the new, say even 2012, Pesach, you understand, or going forward. This is a meditation. No longer is it as Israel coming out of Egypt, but from the north country. You understand? And we're talking about North America and the whole connection with the Ethiopian World Federation. You understand? It's so very, so very evident, the Constitution, the bylaws on a certain level, but at the preamble, our divine heritage, and this particular man right here, Dr. Malakou Emmanuel Bayit Yosin, and the role that he plays in this fulfillment, Yosin, that we have to recognize. It's very important, Yosin, very important for us to recognize these links and connections. You understand? So we as Afro-American Rastafari, we heal as our Jamaican brothers, some of them, and most of them, they heal Marcus Garvey. We heal Dr. Malakou Emmanuel Bayit. And we're just giving you some of the facts and the evidence and the reasons why. You understand? So, brothers and sisters, this is just a basic kind of a message, a reasoning, but we haven't, hopefully we'll catch up on this if it's so desired in another part, you understand, or another lecture. We can go further in this, but read more of this because it's showing you, well, that's the prophetic overview, that king, right? That king, even the king of kings, right, shall reign. You know what I'm saying? And we can see the, you know, that since his time, it's like things were getting a little better, you know what I'm saying? But since that time, things have gotten dramatically, you know what I'm saying, worse. And there's a prophetic reason for that. And in another publication, we can go through the translation of it, but those who can read or desirous of them, Harik, you know, get the Sikare Jesus, the explication of Jesus, of Yeshua, you know what I'm saying, and read His Majesty's testimony, this little book that's written of in Revelation, right? Revelation chapter 10, and this right here as well, the Ethiopic Book of Enoch, which gives I and I more on the backstory. Yes, and explains certain misinterpreted areas of Scripture and of the Bible as well. So my brothers and sisters, may the peace and the grace and the mercy of our Black Lord and Savior Yeshua HaMashiach be with all of you. In Yeshua's name, Shalom Rastafari.